like many children, I was one of those kids that just loved space. And my dad gave me a little toy telescope and I went outside and found Jupiter myself. And that's always something that sticks with you. And I came back to it a few years ago when I, just on a whim, just bought a telescope. It was just after tax time, so I had $1,000 in my pocket and I blew it on this telescope. And I thought that was a lot of money for a telescope. But a few months after that, I realised it wasn't really a lot of money for a telescope. And now I'm really in the hole. I suppose just looking at the stars is considered astronomy, but what I do is astrophotography. So it's taking lots of exposures and then stacking them. And by stacking them, you can pull out more detail, more clarity, more colour. And so I get these high resolution images of deep space objects, but as well as planets and the moon and the sun and all the things that are close to us, there's also things that are many hundreds of light years, or hundreds or thousands of light years away, like the deep space nebulas, galaxies and things like that, and that we can also image right from our backyards. I was really lucky when I brought the telescope home, my first telescope. I didn't realise at the time just how lucky we have it in Byron Bay. We are 28 degrees south of the equator. We can see things like the moon and the sun with less atmosphere between us and the object. And couple that with the fact that Byron Bay has very low light pollution, it really opened up the whole sky for me. I got what's called the Sky Shed Pod, which is a kit observatory that allows you to set up a whole dome, which means as soon as it's dark, I can walk outside, flick a switch, and I'm ready to go. The first image that really went viral for me was the International Space Station across the surface of the moon. When I published that image, once it had gone out through the mainstream media, things like the Weather Channel and CNN and stuff like that, then NASA took notice, and then the International Space Station astronauts themselves, Scott Kelly and Chris Hadfield, both noticed, and then JPL and all of these organisations from within the space industry were suddenly retweeting and sharing the image out. And off the back of that, the European Space Agency invited me to go to Western Australia, and I helped photograph their deep space tracking station down there and did some nightscape photography for them as well. And I've kept in contact with them, and they've published quite a few of my images since then as well. When you spend all this money on your hobby, you want to share it with others. And so tonight we have the local cub group coming over. Hopefully I'll be able to help them get their astronomy badge or their space badge. Yep, try not to hold the telescope, that's it.
Whoa, whoa.
You see that nice and clear? I have a mission to get the science out there for people, so I hope that people see the images and they're engaged, and I'll talk anyone's ear off if they want to hear me talk about space, and kids are very good for that.